So today we'll see a very interesting, very easy topic, viewing contents in a table. As you all know, to view content of a table, you use a query called select. Okay, you can either have select star, or you know, you can have column 1, column 2, etc. from table name, where you can give a condition. Okay, so this is how you work on your select query. Why do you select query? To see the content inside a table, you use the select query. You use it very often, like, you know, I'll just show you a simple example. Select star from STU details. Okay, now as you know, when you give select star from, all the details of student details will come up. Let's see how it happens. You very much know that you've been working on that in and out. You will be getting all these details. Now imagine you want to have a selective display. You don't want all these details to come in. You just want to know the name, city and gender. Okay, S underscore name, city and gender, you can give your query like select S underscore name, city, gender. Okay, I'm using this portion, selective displaying. I don't want everything to come. Everything to come means we need a star, but you need only some particular columns to come up. So you will use the exact column names. Okay, now look here, I give it, I get only the name, only the city, and only the gender. Okay, so this is how a select query will work. You can even give conditions together with your select query. Okay, for example, I'll work on the same query again. Imagine my question is, display the name, city, and gender of all the students who come from Kochi. So I'll give where city equal to Kochi. Okay, Kochi should happen in single quotes because it is a varkar. Okay, so you know, I will be displaying only the details of students from Kochi. Okay, look here. These are all my students, Rahul, Dhanya, Devika, Tina, Manu, out of which only Rahul and Dhanya are from Kochi. Okay, now imagine I can have a question like, display the details of all students, all girl students in Kochi. Okay, all the girl students who are from Kochi. So I'll just simply add and. A-N-D, and is a keyword, and is a keyword, and is a keyword, okay? And gender is equal to female, okay? So now what I'm doing is I'm selecting the name, city, and gender of all the students who are from Kochi, and also gender female, very simple. Display details of female students in Kochi. That's it. Okay, didn't get copied. We'll copy it. I'll paste it. Look here. Dhanya is the only female from Kochi. You can check whether I'm correct. Kochi, female, only Dhanya. Okay, you can even go on adding up this query. Like, you know, let's say you can have things like from Kochi or Punjab. Okay, you can have or, or is also a keyword, or control C, control V, city is equal to Punjab. Okay, now what I'm meaning over here is, I'll just make it a bit more smaller so that you can see that in a single line. Okay, so what am I doing here? Either from Kochi or Punjab, and she should also be a female. Either from Kochi or from Punjab and a female. Okay. And gender equal to female. Okay. Rahul came up. Okay. Too many ors and ands. It isn't working. Okay. We'll see that later. Okay. Kochi or Punjab. Okay. So the similarly, you can work with or and. Or and in your conditions. So we'll see something called wild card characters. Wild card characters. It's simple and even interesting. Okay, so I have a simple question. Find out the names of students whose name start with the letter D. Start with the letter D. Okay. Have the next question. End with the letter A. Name of students whose name end the letter A. Who have an A at the second position. Who have an A at the second position. Okay, next question. Starts with T, whose name starts with T, ends with A. Starts with T, ends with A. Okay, so have another question. Starts with R, ends with L, starts with R, ends with L. And has a H in between. And has a H in between. Okay. Now, for these kind of textual combinations, okay, for textual combinations, we use the wildcard characters. We will be using the wildcard characters. There are lots of wildcard characters with respect to various versions of SQL. As of now, in the current 11G SQL version which we work, we do have something called percentage, which means zero or more. Percentage, which means zero or more. We even have underscore. Underscore, which means a single character. Underscore, which means a single character. Okay. So now I'll just have a simple query so that we will get to know how to work on it. Okay. Now, these wildcard characters, they work on your select query mostly. Okay. So what was my first question? My first question was names which start with D. Okay. Now your wildcard characters, they work with a keyword called like. L-I-K-E. We have seen it a few classes before, and then I told you we will learn it in detail later. Anyway, you do have an idea about how to work with like. Okay, so all these, they work with the keyword called like. Now, what was my question? Select the name. You can have more than one thing. Select the name and city or whatever, or select star, anything from student details. Where, what was my question in hand? Where the name starts with D. Okay. Name starts with D. Okay. Now, starts with D means the first letter should be D. The remaining can be anything, which means D percentage. Okay. The starting should be D, nothing else. The remaining, any number of characters. So I write D percentage, where S name like D percentage. Okay. So this query will give you the names which start with D. I'll just copy it. I'll paste it there. Okay, so these are my details. Copy, paste. Okay, select the name and city of all the students who start with D. Start with D, the remaining I am not bothered. Okay, now imagine you want to find out ends with A. Okay, which means the ending should be A. I'm very sure the ending should be A. Before A, I am not bothered. I am not bothered whatever comes before A. It could be a single character. It would be 100 characters. It could be 5 characters. I am not bothered. So the reverse ends with A. Okay. So I'll just write this query once again. Okay. It is not starting with D. Instead, it is ends with A. Mind you, small a will be different, big A will be different because it is a string. I will be treating a small a and a big A completely differently. Okay, so I'll just copy this. I'll put it over here. Okay, ends with A. Look into my parent table. I do have 3 people ending with A. Before that, whatever is it, I'm not bothered. Number of characters, I'm not bothered. I'm only bothered about ending with A. Okay, so I write percentage A, ends with A. Okay, so next is not ends with A, nothing. A, it's A, okay, small a, at the second position. Okay, now let's come back to our table. Now look here. Take your parent table. A at the second position. Look here. You have such a record. You have 2 records. You have Rahul and you have Manu. Okay. At the second position, which means there should be something in the first position. There should compulsorily be something in the first position. Second position, you have an A. Remaining, you are not bothered. Okay. First position, there should be something. Okay. So I will write underscore, a single character. There should be a character in the first position. There should be whatever it is, I don't bother, but there should be a character. The second should be A, and the remaining should be percentage. Okay. Look here. First position, there should be something. That compulsory character will be taken care by underscore. Then you will have A remaining. Look here, three characters over here, two characters only over here. So to take care of the remaining characters, where you're not bothered about how many characters are there, you will give a percentage. Okay, so I'll just copy this again. Okay, it is not percentage A. Instead, it is underscore A percentage. Okay, so let's copy the query and then paste it there. Okay, correctly it came. Rahul Manu. Rahul Manu. First, there is something. There is something. I don't know what it is, but there should be one character. Because there should be one character, I put one underscore. Just one underscore, because I have one character. Then I have A remaining. I have a few characters. Okay. To make it more clear, let us do one more. Which has, you can find out the names which have H as the third character, which have names which have H at the or let's say N at the third character. Okay, let's come back, take your parent table, N at the third character, which means, you know, it's Manu should come as the answer. First character, there should be something. Second character, there should be something. N is my third character. After N, I am not bothered whatever is there. Okay, so I'll write first character, there should be something. Okay, one underscore will take care of that. Second character, there should be something. The second underscore will take care of that. Then I have N. The remaining, I am not bothered. So I give a percentage. I'll copy the same thing again. I'll put it over here. Okay, two underscores. Double underscore to take care of my first two characters. I'll copy this. I'll paste it over here. Okay. Like, just a minute. The error was, look here. Somehow when I typed, I had an extra space over here. Okay. That space was a problem. I corrected my query, leaving away the space. Now it works perfectly. I only have Manu. Manu's perfect. Look here. First character, I'm not bothered. But there should be a character. Second character, I'm not bothered. Third should be an N. Remaining any number of characters are fine. Okay. So please take care when you type. I somehow had a space over here because I did a copy paste. Okay. So that is how you find at a particular location. Okay. At a particular location. Okay.
Ma'am, case sensitive, alle, ma'am.
Just a minute. I'll just copy that over here. I'll just copy what Tina told me. Copy N at the fourth position, which means, you know, I have three underscores over there. Okay, I had two people. Dhanya, look here, N at the fourth position, and even N at the fourth position. You were asking about case sensitivity. Strings are case sensitive. Strings are case sensitive. Okay, I'll work the same query with a capital N. Okay, I will not get an answer simply because in my records, I don't have any record which has capital N at the fourth position. Very simple, it will not work. It is case sensitive, very much case sensitive. Strings are case sensitive. Okay, so we'll go for the next one. Starts with T and ends with A. Okay, it's very simple. You should begin it with T. You should end it up with A. In between, anything can happen, isn't it? Starting it with A, T, it is a combination of these two together. A combination of these two. Starting with D, ending with A. I just combined both of them together. Okay. Starts with T, ends with A. T beginning, A at the end. In between, anything can happen. I'm not bothered. Okay. So I'll just write that. Starts with T, in between, anything, and then ending up with A. I'll copy my query. I'll paste it over there. Okay. Starts with T, ends with A. Remaining, anything is fine. Okay, I'll just make a small change. Starts with D and ends with A. I think I should be getting more rows for that. Okay, look here, Dhanya and Devika. Perfect it is. Starts with D, ends with A. In between, I'm not bothered. Anything inside is okay for me. So this was my next question. R at the first, L at the last, H in between. So first, let's think of such a record. Okay. Oh, you'll have to have everything small, okay? Because here also it is small. R at the first, L at the last, and H in between. Very simple. Just modify this. Okay. R in the beginning. Okay. L at the end. H in between. Very simple. Very simple. I'll just copy this and paste it over there. Okay, I'll get Rahul. We'll just search for Devika. Okay, D in the beginning, A at the end, and let's say a random character V in between. Okay, D, A, and V somewhere in between. V should come somewhere in between. Okay, it comes out perfect. Okay, so this is how you work with combinations. So I have a question. Find details, find name and city, file name and city of students whose CID is 58. Whose CID is 58? Very simple. Name and city of students whose CID is equal to 58. Mind you, 58 was a number. That is why I did not give it in quotes. We are simply working on random queries. Okay, I've got 58, two people. Yeah, Dhanya and Devika, they came. Okay, now have the next question. Display details of students whose CID not equal to 58. Whose CID is not 58. Okay, now to work on the not query, not, you have this exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. So very simple. Okay. Not equal to 58. Pure mathematics. Okay. So all the students who are not equal to 58 come up. Just a minute. I didn't copy it. Copy. paste. Okay, not equal to 58. Rahul, Tina, Manu. Okay, these two people are 58. Okay, remaining everything, not equal to 58. Rahul, Tina, and Manu. 55, 77, 78. Now, let's have something more interesting. Find the name of students whose CID is in the range of 50 to 60. Whose CID is in a range 50 to 60. Hope you got the question. Okay. Whose CID range is 50 to 60, which means, you know, it should be greater than 50, but less than 60. Very simple. You use the and, okay? You don't have something like a range, okay? Instead, you'll combine it with and, where CID is, okay, greater than 50, pure mathematics, and CID should also be less than 60. So I've programmed my range perfectly. It should be greater than 50 and less than 60. Okay, I'll just copy it and put it over there. Okay, so let's check. I'll just put a select. I'll just confirm select star from STU underscore details. STU underscore details. Okay, so let's check between 50 and 60. 58. Okay, only these three. Rahul, Dhanya, Devika. Oh, it's come out perfect. Rahul, Dhanya, Devika. So this is how you work with a range in SQL. Have a question. Calculate double the age of each student. Okay. Calculate double the age of each student. Okay. Which means, okay, first we'll find out the age of each student. Select name and age from student details. Okay. So first let's calculate the age and let's see how it looks like. Okay. So now I've got the age of each student. What is the question? Calculate the double the age of each student. So you need to calculate double the age. So I'll just simply write age into 2. That's it. I will be getting display the first column as F name, the second column as age, and the third age into 2, which is nothing but double of this age. Okay, so we'll just copy it and paste it over there. Too simple it is. Okay, name, age, and age into 2. Okay, so you know, Devika, after 22 years old, more, she'll be 44 years old. Tina would be 46 and Manu will be 46. Calculate double the age. Oh my God, this doesn't look good, doesn't it? Age into 2. We'll do one thing. We'll just rename it. Okay. So you can give age into 2, let's say twice the age, TH, as you are renaming it as TH. Age into 2, don't have it as age into 2. Instead, we'll give a new name called TH. Just copy it. I'll put it over here. Yeah. Okay. So I got the name, I got the age, I even got twice the age. I was not happy with age into 2. So I gave a new field called TH. But mind you, this TH will not be there in your table. It's just for your temporary calculations. TH will not go into your table. TH TH will not go into your table. It is just for your happiness, your temporary view. You get to see that particular table. Okay, let's say you want to find age into 2.1234. That also is very much possible. Okay, it always need not be a whole number. Okay, look here, 46.7148. You can do any kind of your math magic over there. And let's say you want to round it off. Okay, hope you remember the round function. Okay, round to how many decimal points? Let's say to 2 decimal points. Okay, round it off to 2 decimal points. Okay, so I've rounded off to, look here, 7148. It remains at 7.71 itself. 8382, it's got rounded off at 84, 71. This got 84, 84. Okay, so this is how you work to make manipulations of an existing field.